ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय वसुदेवसुतं देवं कंसचाणूरमर्दनं देवकी परमानन्दं कृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरुं. When you think of Krishna, immediately a beautiful picture comes before the mind. Holding a lovely flute in his hand and a peacock feather on the head with a smiling face. A question comes to our mind. There are innumerable instruments in this world, but why did Krishna choose this flute? Neither it is very costly, nor it is a great instrument with too many complications. Why? It is just a bamboo grown in the forest. Look at the beauty of this. See, when the bamboo is young, as a small sapling, it grows straight. And when it grows big and very tall, it bends. What is the message it is giving? When you become rich, either in money, knowledge, or position, be humble and bend. Be simple like the bamboo. Don't be arrogant. Krishna chose this bamboo as the instrument and he loved it so much because of its humble nature and simplicity. Flute as an instrument has 9 holes and it is hollow inside. When Krishna holds in his hand and keeps it near his mouth and blows the air into it, it gives a melodious music, very soothing to the heart of the listener. It has a great philosophy behind it. Human body is also called as Navadvarapura. It has got 9 exits. You remove the ego, become hollow like the bamboo, become empty, and surrender to God. Then He holds you in His hand and blows the bliss inside and makes the whole life a beautiful melodious music. Let us become like bamboo and be a flute in the hand of Lord Krishna and enjoy the bliss of life. Kasturi वक्षस्थली कौस्तुभं नासाग्रे नवमौक्तिकं करतले वेणुकरे कङ्कणं सर्वाङ्गे हरिचन्दनञ्च कलयन् कण्ठेषु मुक्तावलिं गोपस्त्री परिवेष्टितो विजयते गोपालचूडामणिः गोपस्त्री परिवेष्टितो विजयते गोपालचूडामणिः सर्वं श्रीकृष्णार्पणमस्तु.